Good morning. I am Soumya, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechatronics Engineering, Hindustan College of Engineering and Technology. I am going to do the presentation on the topic centrifugal casting, which comes under special casting process. So, what all we are going to see under centrifugal casting is that introduction, true centrifugal casting, semi-centrifugal casting, centrifuge casting, advantages, disadvantages, and finally applications. So what is centrifugal casting? So in centrifugal casting, we'll be having a permanent mold. So that is rotated about its axis of high speeds, that is from 300 to 3000 RPM as a molten metal is poured. So in this molten metal, so it will be poured in the mold and allowed to solidify. Okay, so while the mold is rotating, the metal is poured into the center of the mold at its own rotation, own axis rotation. So due to the centrifugal force, so the liquid metal is thrown out towards the periphery. So the molten metal, just as I told you, we have centrifugal force. So centrifugally thrown towards the inside mold, that is towards the periphery, where it solidifies after getting cooled. So the casting is usually a fine grain casting with a very fine grained outer diameter, which is resistant to atmospheric corrosion. So you have to use the material for doing this casting process, that inner diameter and the outer diameter, what we are using is as a mold. It should have the properties of having a corrosion resistance, and well, that is a typical pipe with situations with the pipe. So the inside diameter has more pure impurities and inclusions which can be machined away. So having all these properties, we are still going to see what is a centrifugal casting. So it is both the gravity and the pressure which is independent, since it creates its own force, that is what we call it a centrifugal force, using a temporary sand mold that is held in a spinning chamber up to we use a 900 newton. So the lead time that varies with the application, semi and true centrifugal process. So that will be that comes under the classification of the centrifugal casting. Okay, semi centrifugal casting and true centrifugal casting. So that it permits 30 to 50 pieces per hour for the mold that is to be produced. So with the practical limit for batch processing of approximately, like you can say, 9000 kilogram. Total mass with a typical per item limit of 2.3 to 4.5 kilogram. Okay. So now let's see in detail of centrifugal casting. So it is a family of casting process in which the mold is rotated at high speed, so centrifugal force distributes molten metal to outer regions of the die cavity. So here the centrifugal force plays a major role in shaping and feeding of the casting. So in this process, the mold is rotated rapidly, that is very fast, about its central axis as the metal is poured into it. So the centrifugal force is utilized to distribute liquid metal over the outer surface of the mold. Hollow cylinders and other annular shapes are formed this way. Centrifugal force, it tends the poured metal and the freezing metal to fly outward away from the axis of the rotation, and this tendency creates high pressure on the metal or casting with a lighter slag, oxides and other inclusions being lighter and get pushed towards the center. So the axis may be horizontal, vertical or inclined. Okay, so the casting cools or solidifies from outside towards the axis of rotation, so it results in good directional solidification. So hence casting are free from shrinkage. It may be produced in metal or sand lined mold, depending largely upon the quantity desired. So here we have the group which includes true centrifugal casting. Like I told you in the previous slide, we have classification of centrifugal casting, so true centrifugal, semi-centrifugal, finally centrifuge casting. So let's see what is a centrifugal casting. Okay, so the molten metal is poured into a rotating mold, produce a tubular parch. So So this can be made, okay, with help of this type of casting process. In some operations, the mold rotation commences after pouring rather than before. So it can be horizontal or vertical, like I've told you. Parts, what all the parts can be made here is that we have pipe, tubes, bushings or rings. So outside, the shape of the casting can be round, octagonal, hexagonal. So inside shape will be theoretically round due to radially symmetrical forces. So next one, here is the case. So you can see molten metal will be poured into it. So this will be rotating. So we have a drive roller and free roller, driving and driven. So you know that very well. And because of this rotation, the mold will be rotated, and finally at the time the molten metal will be poured into it. So automatically, because of this centrifugal force, the molten metal will be pushed towards the periphery, okay, by making a mold out of it. Okay, so that we have semi-centrifugal casting. So semi-centrifugal casting, we have a centrifugal force once again, okay. So it is used to produce solid casting rather than tubular parts. In the previous slide, we have seen the true centrifugal casting process. We are going to make only the tubular parts, but here we are going to make solid castings. Okay, it is somewhat similar to the true centrifugal casting, but only with the difference is that central core that is used to form the inner surface. So here again, the casting process is generally used for articles that are more complicated than the possible in a true centrifugal, that is a centrifugal casting, but are asymmetric in nature. Before one is asymmetric, this one asymmetric. A particular shape of the casting is produced by mold and core and not by centrifugal force. So molds are designed with the risers at a center to supply feed metal. Okay, so finally the centrifugal force aids proper feeding and helps in producing the casting free from porosity. Okay, so the density of the metal in final casting is greater in outer section than at the center of the rotation. So in this, you can generally make components like flywheels, gears, back wheels that are produced. Okay, so this is the diagram which is shown. So you have a pouring basin here, we have a casting, cope and drag you have, okay. So you know what is cope and drag. If you have very well known about the casting process, that is a very most oldest method, cope and the drag. And we have flask over here and revolving table. Okay, so here when a group of small molds are arranged in a circle, okay, so to balance each other around the central vertical axis of the flask, and the flask is rotated about the vertical axis, the process is called as a centrifuge casting. So this is what the centrifuge casting is. So it is clear that the molds are not symmetrical about the axis of the rotation. So that is the axis of casting and the axis of rotation that do not coincide with one another. Here again, the centrifugal force is used to obtain higher pressure on the metal and get more dense casting. So the molten metal will flow to all the molds under centrifugal force from a central feeding screw. So here the mold is designed with the part cavities located away from axis of rotation, so that molten metal poured into the mold is distributed to the cavities by centrifugal force. So it is especially to make a smaller parts. So you can just can compare three different types of centrifugal casting. First one is a true centrifugal, semi-centrifugal and centrifuge casting. First one, true centrifugal casting is to make tubular parts. Next one, solid casting for semi-centrifugal, and centrifuge casting, it is used to make smaller parts. So centrifuge casting is still need to get explanation. So only cylindrical shapes can be produced with this process. So there are some limitations for the size, like 3 meters in other terms 10 feet diameter and 15 meter or 50 feet length. And then we have typical materials. So what all the materials that can be casted using this type of centrifugal casting process is that can make iron, steel, stainless steel, alloys of aluminium, copper and nickel. So we can also cast two different materials by introducing a second material during the process. Okay, so not only one particular material we used, we can use other two materials also. Okay, so typical parts made by this process. So what all the process you can make is just, that is especially for the smaller parts. So pipe, boilers, pressure vessels, flywheels, cylindrical liners, other parts, that is axisymmetric. So now we are going to see what are all the advantages of centrifugal casting. So it eliminates the mid ball defects. So any other defects that can be reduced, and it controls the impurities. That is, in the beginning itself I told you, you can able to avoid the corrosion, right? So corrosion and resistance is there. So it can able to reduce the micro porosity. Good foundry practice is required. And coming to the disadvantages, L by D ratio and cost is higher, and shape and mold cost is higher. Small insert diameter, safety and cost. So these are all the disadvantages of centrifugal casting. Good foundry practices is also required. So without any having any training, you cannot do this centrifugal casting. So coming to the applications of centrifugal casting process, we can able to cast this in components like propeller hubs, compressors, cast rings, flanges, shaft sleeves and liners, aircraft loading systems in aircraft manufacturing. Next one, in automobiles, you can make components like cylindrical liners, piston rings, transmission systems, bearing bushes, gear blank. And in petroleum processing plants, pump and valve housing, furnace tubes, ethylene coils, tube trees, elbow and fittings, high pressure fluid pipes. In power plants, steam turbine bearing shells, turbine heat exchangers can be cast out. In electronics, you can make switchgear components. That's all for today's presentation. Thanks for listening. Thank you all.